half a sheep covering.
The arts of the etheria.
The etheria.
Earlier on this evening, I was watching the television and noticed the Grammy. I thought it was the Grammy Awards. I looked it up. It was the Oscars, and we've been looking at some pictures from the Oscars now for 2016. And the stage there, well, you have the Grammy Award that would relate surely to the Egyptian creator god Ptah or Ptah. And obviously you have the magic circle right there, and interestingly you have the staffs there also, and I have a depiction of that within the Adania game there with the staffs, magic circle. And looking at, I'll just add to this video, there were other things about the Grammy Awards and the imagery and all the rest of it, but beyond that, because you just see it everywhere, it would seem. So with the third degree tracing board of Freemasonry, you have in this shot, just notice how you have the central participant, and just take the coffin as the participant, take that as the aura of the participant, and around it you will see the imbued figures around the participant in this Masonic artwork. It's absolutely unmistakable. We'll go on to this image here from tracingboards.com, and you can see those imbued figures right there. Looking at the third degree tracing board here, you can see the outer ring with the five, what would be the five participants there, surely in this case, and then below that you can see the circumpunct there also. So I've been talking about the third degree tracing board a lot lately. It's a very revealing tracing board. Here's some old footage I took of a ritual book where you'll see reference to the elements within there. This happens to be written in German, this piece. But so anyway, I just thought I'd make this quick video. I don't want to bore people with my stuff, but for those watching, this is about actual magic rituals. So just to drag this out a bit, but to try and ram it home with this image here, it's based on the third degree tracing board, it's Masonic. You can see the five regions to the outside there with the slight variation in colour. Now this would be the individual, and you can see the skull and bones there. You know, we've left the bones, we've left the flesh, if you will. This is the aura of the human body imbued with one of the elements, imbued with an etheric element, and they are to the outside there. You can see that they're kind of linked, and if you look carefully at the artwork, there's a bit of a link up with the subtle colors and bits and pieces that are used. You can see the kind of ropey looking design around it that links all of them together. And indeed you can see this. Now this artwork here with the five, this is off that sort of Australian version of the third degree tracing board, although you can see it on the third degree tracing board, and you can even see the chain there. So the chain, the light. But anyway, so they're all linked together, and as the energies flow around that outer circle, that's where you would get the circumpunct, I would deeply suspect. And we'll notice now that with the circumpunct, you have the dot in the center. So all of the energy now is, well, the energies have been transferred into the center. The energies have been transferred into the center. Indeed, if we go to Egypt, you can see the energies being transferred to the mage in the center. And indeed, you can see this over and over and over again as I show. So I just wanted to show this within the artwork there. I think when you put this all together, it's quite blatant, actually. It's quite obvious.